one of the most successful, indeed the most successful boxing nation in the history of the sport in the Olympic Games, United States of America. And here is their 19-year-old from Fresno in California, Joseph Diaz Jr., one of a nine-strong American team. And his opponent from the Ukraine, who've got no fewer than seven boxers from the 10 divisions. And this is another comparatively young man, Pavlo Ishchenko, born in Russia, that represents the Ukraine. He's coached by his dad, Oleg, incidentally. Diaz Jr. is going to find himself in the red corner. Ishchenko, they haven't got the headgear on yet. The referee will come across to check that the headgear is in position, that the vests are perfectly tucked in so that the white waistband can be seen to judge whether or not a blow is above the waistband or not. The all-important cup protector is checked, and of course a boxer is not allowed to start boxing unless he has got the gum shield in. So the Chinese referee has just come across to the American corner. And this is the opposite corner, the blue corner, with Pavlo Ishchenko from Ukraine. Ukraine had a very, very good World Championships last year in Baku and Azerbaijan. They had no fewer than four gold medalists, all of whom qualified straight away. Gloves checked. Diaz looking, well, quietly confident. Got himself to the quarterfinals of the World Championships last year to qualify here.
And in the blue corner, representing Ukraine, Pavlo Ishchenko.
Referee has checked that the judges are all happy. And the referee is happy, and away we go. Bout number one of 272 in the Olympic Game Boxing Tournament 2012. In the red, just to remind you, Joseph Diaz Jr. from the United States, the teenager from California. His opponent only a year older, 20 years of age, in blue, Pavlo Ishchenko from the Ukraine.
Straight away, Jim, Diaz is a southpaw, so could make things awkward for his Ukrainian opponent. But Ishchenko straight away there, just worked to the body well. So yeah, it's going to be interesting, this one. Southpaw against an orthodox boxer always creates problems, mainly for the orthodox boxer.
And having had a couple of Olympics with four two-minute rounds, we're back to the more traditional three-minute rounds. How much do you think that could make a difference for some boxers?
Oh, definitely. Four twos is a totally different type of contest. It's a tic-tac, more speed and movement, less emphasis on power. 3-3 is totally different. The power element comes into it, which, you know, should play a part in amateur boxing.
Well, lovely variation by the American, who's ranked number 12 in the world. Lost in the quarterfinals of the World Championships last year to the eventual gold medal winner, Alvarez from Cuba, who's seeded number one for this tournament and has got a bye, and he may well wait. Diaz may well meet him if he gets through this one, and he's making a good job of it. Remember, 3 minutes, five judges at ringside, and to record a scoring punch on the computer system, you've got to satisfy the judges that you land with the knuckle part of the glove on the head or the torso with sufficient force. Now, we don't see the running scores anymore, which probably makes life a bit more difficult for the observers. And the scores will come up at the end of the round. And with the five judges, the highest and the lowest scores are discarded, and then they take an average of the remaining three. But the computer really does all the work, and you'll see the scores at the end of the round. And apart from the occasional little furry, and that wasn't a bad right hand, that was a slip. It's been Diaz who's looked the more impressive of the two in this opening stanza.
Yeah, I'm quite impressed with his hand speed at this stage, Diaz. He's coming forward. A lot of southpaws tend to sit back, but he's a southpaw on the front foot coming forward. Fast hands. What he's got to watch out for, Jim, is the left hook from Ishchenko. There it is there. And if he doesn't watch what he's doing there, Diaz, he's going to get caught with that left hook as he's coming forward. Always a good shot to throw against the southpaw because it's delivered outside the line of vision.
It's all about getting your feet right against the southpaw. What you don't want to do is get your lead foot inside the southpaw's right lead foot, because going to be vulnerable on a couple of fronts. Just about 30 seconds remaining, and it's been a very entertaining start to what promises to be a couple of weeks of absolutely mesmerizing boxing here in the XL Center. Ishchenko has come back into this a little bit more, and he's got his defense right. He was a little bit loose. That was a good little stiff right hand through by the American, and a left to follow.
Yeah, he's had a better last 30 or 40 seconds, but I think, for me, Diaz has worked a lot harder. He's throwing more punches. He's up the tempo a little bit. Nice, sneaky little shot there from him. And again, just catching his opponent off guard. That's good stuff from the American.
A couple of seconds to go, and then for the very first time, we shall see the new system of scoring on the computer system on the screen in the Olympic Games. Not a bad round at all by the youngster Diaz. A little bit of action from that first round. There was that left hook that Diaz is going to have to be careful about. I think he just about blocked it and no more. Both of them with very high guards, and that's good defense by Ishchenko, but a very sweet little uppercut came through with the right hand of the American. He's trying to just press that open, and that was the shot from a different angle at the end of that round. 1 point between them, according to the computer scoring screen, which is high above the there it is on our screens, above the ring. 4-3 just to Diaz. He probably in his corner probably thought that he might have been a little bit more up than that. The Korean judge had Diaz winning that opening round by 6-3. Very interesting. So 4-3 to Diaz in the red, representing America. He's a student at the Fresno State University.
Yeah, slight change of tactics now from Ishchenko. He knows that he's obviously behind. I thought the American was probably 2 or 3 points more up, to be quite honest, but the Ukrainian corner have told him, listen, you're behind, you've got to go on the front foot a little bit more, take it to him, and that's what he's doing in this round. Better start from Ishchenko.
Ishchenko lost his opening contest in the World Championships in Baku in Azerbaijan last year, and had to qualify through the European qualifiers, which were held in Turkey, and he won that tournament in pretty impressive form, beating boxers from Armenia, then the 2008 bronze medalist from 4 years ago from Moldova, Vyacheslav Gojan, then a boxer from Sweden, and then had a walkover in the final against the boxer from Denmark, who didn't turn up for that. I think he was injured.
Well, Diaz here, Jim, is boxing very well again. He's up the tempo, and he's working a lot harder than Ishchenko. The problem Ishchenko has got here, he's relying too much on single punches. He's going for power. He's waiting for his opening and just watching for that one shot. There it is again. But he's not working hard enough. And again, although his guard is very good, Diaz is getting through with more shots.
A couple of good body shots going in from both of them. Ishchenko looks a little bit more lively. He's bouncing around just momentarily for a second or two, maybe trying to draw Diaz onto him. But of course, that's the classic technique by a southpaw. They like you to come forward and then they try to pick you off.
See, a couple of good shots. That was a lovely body shot there from Ishchenko, but it's only a single punch. And normally body shots, pretty hard to score, pretty hard to see, especially if your opponent's got his elbows tucked in nice. Has the punch landed? Now and again, the judges can be a little bit unsure.
You got to buy when you box in the Olympics. I mean, would you rather have actually got straight into it?
Straight into it, yeah. Jim. Buys are no good for anyone, believe you me. You've trained so hard, you're ready and waiting. And if you get a buy in the first round, it doesn't do you any favours at all.
Diaz coming forward, trying to force the pace a little bit, Rich, but he's got himself caught as he comes in. Ishchenko's just sticking to a fairly rigid game plan.
Yep, and there's that left hand again.
Yep.
The left hook he's got to watch out for. Also, Ishchenko likes to work the body with that right hook especially. But I just think he's been outworked. I think the American's working a lot better, a lot harder. And although Ishchenko, again, his guard is very high, he's blocking a lot of shots. But I think the American's outworked him again in this round.
That's a pretty good division with the world number one, Lazaro Alvarez Estrada from Cuba, and an excellent boxer from Azerbaijan, Magomed Abdulhamidov, at the other end of the draw. Last second, Diaz pressing and may just have landed in time. Not much between them, but maybe another American round, Rich. What do you think?
Yeah, I think he just sneaked it again there. He worked a lot harder than Ishchenko. Ishchenko had some quality single punches, but were they getting through? The power was definitely there, but I think the American, the volume was a lot better. We're coming forward here, working to the body well, switching the attack, going from body to head, keeping his man at bay also. Better round for the American.
Yeah, took that by a two-point margin this time. 5-3 to Diaz in the second round. And he's going into the third and last round, 3 points up, leading by 9-6. And there's confirmation. Alas, we don't have the running scores for you, but that's the decision made by the governing body of the sport, AIBA, the Amateur International Boxing Association. So the world-rated number 12, Joseph Diaz Jr. in the most recent AIBA ratings, is leading the non-rated Ukrainian. Ukraine brought a seven-man team here, four of them reigning world champions. Americans have brought nine.
The anticipated response now from Ishchenko. It's all or nothing now. If he loses this round, he's going out of these Olympic Games. So he's got to go. He's got to take the fight to his opponent, try and slug it out a little bit, and try and land those better quality punches. Good start again from the Ukraine.
Well, he really has to force the pace now, and he's doing that. This is going to be a real test of Diaz's resolve. He's never really been in the back foot. He's come forward, and he's used that southpaw jab of his very nicely. And that's fast hands by the American. Clever punching. Now, is this going to be a standing cut? No, there's something. Oh, it's just a chin strap. That's all right. I thought for a split second there the referee might have been thought about giving a standing eight count against Ukrainian. But it's just a little bit of something had come loose underneath the chin of the American.
I'm impressed with Diaz, Jim. I think he's boxed excellent here. He's kept a good guard. He's stuck to his boxing. He's worked well at mid-range, short range, and he's worked behind his jab also. This is a good performance from this American.
Judging by the sweat on the back of his vest, he's got himself well warmed up for this. Packed arena here in the XL Centre. 2 minutes to go. This has been a terrific contest to open the tournament, Richie.
Yeah, good right hook to the body there. And again from Diaz. He hurts his opponent there. Switches to that left uppercut. Super left hand. Good work.
Well, Diaz is really turning it on now. There was a little flurry at the start of the round by the Ukrainian, who's a year older. But the teenager from California is putting on a very stylish demonstration here. He's blocked those shots very nicely, and that clever corkscrew right hand of his has got in once again. Well, the Ukrainian had to close a three-point gap. He needed four unanswered points to win this, and he may have scored a couple, but I don't think he's done enough, Rich.
No, he hasn't. He's walking on to punches left, right and centre here. That's another good right hook, and that left uppercut going
in for
Diaz. Super, super work.
Well, that was a good left hand, and the referee had a good long look at the Ukrainian. Diaz has been very slick and very clever, and has shown a terrific variation.
High tempo as well, high work rate from both boxers. I mean, Ishchenko is still going for it, but the better quality work now is coming from the American. Oh, lovely shot. Great punch that was there. Just brought him onto it. Well timed.
4-3 at the end of the first. 5-3 at the end of the second in favour of the man in red. The 19-year-old from California representing the United States of America, who haven't, well, since 1984, when they won 9 out of 12 available gold medals, had a really strong Olympics. Long way to go for this fellow, mind you. But it looks as if Joseph Diaz Jr. has come through and is going to win this one, less than 30 to go.
Yeah, and I think it's good tactics here, Jim, as well, from this American. The first 2 minutes of this round have been very, very high work rate. Now he's just stepped off the gas a touch in this last minute. He knows he's home and dry. He's just got to stay safe now.
Don't push from the Chinese referee. All signals, apart from the three verbal commands of stop, break and box, are given by the referee in terms of hand signals. And there's a recognised highway code, if you like, in international boxing. And that's the end of the last one. And don't be surprised if it's an American victory. And Joseph Diaz Jr., who goes over to his opponent's corner and says thank you very much indeed, I'm sure has won this one. And it's a question of just by, well, how big a margin. Really up the work rate in the last round. 4-3, then 5-3, 9-6 going into the final 3 minutes. Just a little bit of action there. It was a good last round from
him. Lovely work there. That left uppercut and left hook from Diaz there. Super work. Again, works well with that left uppercut, right hook to finish. I thought it was a good performance, and what a great contest to open these Olympic Games with. Some quality boxing there from both of them, but the better work definitely came from the American. Good variation, good hook to the body there, super punch that was, and that left uppercut in that last round here, one comes through the middle, super punch.
Well, if they're all as good and as exciting and as skillful and as entertaining as this one, Richie, it'll be well worth the price of admission. Interesting hairstyle from Mr. Ishchenko. Giant screen above the ring has not yet put up the judges' scores for the final round and therefore the score at the end of the contest, but I'm pretty sure that the hand going to be raised is the hand of the young man in red from the United States of America, Joseph Diaz Jr. What a cracking opener. Another 271 of them, remember.
Here ladies and gentlemen, the winner by a score of 19-9 in the red corner, representing the United States of America, Joseph Diaz Jr.
Well, 11-2, Pavlo, 10-3 I should say, he won that last round, 19-9, a high scoring last round. His opponent got 6 but he picked up 10, and there's the story in terms of the stats, 19-9, and the first winner in the boxing tournament here in the Excel Centre, London 2012, is from the United States of America, Joseph Diaz Jr.